Got Labor Day weekend coming up.
We do.
And with that comes the 57th annual Newtown Labor Day Parade on Monday, September 3rd. And the committee president is on the phone with us right now, Nick Kopczyk. Morning, Nick.
Hey, Nick.
Good morning, guys. How you doing?
Good. Good
We're
to
doing
talk
good.
To you.
This is a big-ass parade.
Yeah, it's the largest parade in the state of Connecticut.
That's
on Labor Day.
Yeah.
I actually, I've attended this once. It's fantastic.
Is it?
Yeah.
Did you ride in a convertible?
No. I watched.
No? Okay.
I watched, and I had a shirt on, yeah.
It goes what? It starts at 10.
Starts at 10 o'clock up at the monument, between the monument and the flagpole, and it ends at the on Queen Street at My Place Restaurant. And it takes about 2.5 hours to get from start to finish.
Bring a meal with you.
First exit up.
Yeah.
So... yeah, the people start lining up the chairs the night before to save their spots. It's been going on for over 50 years in town here. It's a pretty big deal.
You know what else they got, Lou? They got a shuttle bus that shuttles people in.
You shuttle?
Because there's so many people at this parade.
Yeah, the axe will park at the end of the parade.
Whoa. Axe?
What axe?
You have axe?
We have axe. We got local bands. We got Elvis Presley's coming. The Philadelphia Mummers.
Wow.
Which is they're a group out of Philadelphia. They're actually I believe they're in the Thanksgiving Day parade.
What do mummers do? Is my question. What are mummers?
Yeah.
Well, they dance. They dance to music and costumes.
And I'm glad they're from Philly. It would have made no sense if they were from Kansas City. I'll tell you what right now.
Yeah.
We got a lot of local businesses in town that will make floats. Some will do skits. The local karate, Porco Karate, usually does their training along the route. They'll stop and do
I remember that was actually very entertaining. That was one of the things that stood out to me when I went to when I attended this parade was the karate.
Did the karate people come out of the line of the parade route and like karate chop?
Didn't they're like going along?
No,
like they keep
no
moving.
Karate chopping.
That's what.
Yeah, they don't hurt anybody. No.
Yeah, no. There's a couple different schools that are in there. They do that. Our grand marshal this year is Eunice Laverty. She owns a local business in town and serving the community is the theme of the parade this year. So. It's fitting that she's our grand marshal. And there's over 100 entries.
Do you have to apply to be in the parade?
You fill out an application so we know you're coming so we can place you in the proper location. There's
gotcha.
A ton of work that the girls, my wife and her co-chairman, do to facilitate this. It's a lot of little details that have to be taken care of. You can't have two bands next to each other.
Of course not.
You don't want to have a loud act with a quiet act, and you're trying to space out the cars and make it flow where you're not seeing repetition, over and over.
If you just joined us, we're talking to the committee president for the 57th annual Newtown Labor Day Parade. I have a very important question. I noticed in the parade New Fairfield, whenever we have one, you got the Boy Scouts or Girl Scouts or Brownies, and they're throwing like Tootsie Rolls and candy out to the crowd. Do you have any of that going on?
We do that. Yeah, the people in the parade do throw candy. It's a big part of it. We ask that you don't throw candy from the moving vehicles because we want to keep the kids away from that. We want everybody to be safe. But that's a huge part of it.
And don't throw Diet Pepsi cans.
That makes a little bit of a mess.
That could hurt, yeah.
It's a great family event. I had a blast. I was actually a plus one for an invited guest to one of the houses right on the main strip there.
Really?
So I had dinner and a show and maybe a cocktail too.
Nice.
Yeah.
So what would you recommend people who want to go to this parade and get a decent seat? Sleep out overnight?
You probably don't have to do that.
Okay.
There's plenty. The route's long enough. There's plenty of spaces along the route to go. Obviously, it's going to be warm on Monday. Queen Street is the shadiest part of it.
Right.
But there's plenty of spots all along the parade route.
My last question for you is, between you and I, what is the best possible place to watch this parade?
The best possible place to see
this parade on Queen Street.
You know what? It's good all the way through. I got to be totally honest with you. There is no. I've watched the parade. I've been in the parade. I've been here 23 plus years, and dealt with the parade at different levels. And there really isn't a bad seat in the house.
Lewis, this parade has its own website.
Okay.
NewtownCTLaborDayParade.org. If you want to find out about the acts and all and who's marching and the whole deal, you go there. It's everything's on there. Hey, Nick.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.
We appreciate it. Thanks, man.
It's going to be awesome.
No problem, guys.
All right.
Yeah, chance. Come on out.
Okay. All right, thanks.